Hey guys, so I'm continuing to talk about my path to U.S. citizenship, and I feel like this will be the last video because I want to show you this little paper. This is it. This is my, this proves that I'm a U.S. citizen. And I got that, you know, after going to the swearing-in ceremony. I didn't think, before going in, I didn't think much of it. I just thought it would just be like, okay, I'll just go in, wait a little while, and, you know, do the swearing-in thingy, and that would be it. And I thought it would be quick and easy. I was in there for a long time, actually. I got there at like 9:30, I believe, and we stayed there till like 1 o'clock. And it was quite amazing. The experience of swearing-in ceremony. You know, I'm in New York City, so we did it in this Brooklyn District Courthouse. And oh wow, like I didn't realize like how it was until the judge came up way later after all the process. There was a lot of process in the swearing ceremony. Some papers you gotta sign, you gotta check, whatever. And also, you have the option to register to vote, which I did. Anyway, after all that, the judge comes out, and he gives out the speech. And the judge's speech was very inspirational, actually. It made me feel patriotic, you know. But he started talking about, like, how in this room, he just, like, was like, oh, I realize there's 151 of us today, you guys today. So 151 immigrants to this country in that room applying to be a U.S. citizen from 51 different countries. That was just like, whoa. And everyone was just like, kind of, whoa, you know. There's so many diversity in that single room. And it was an amazing feeling, you know. And kind of feeling that makes you think only possible in America, you know. And don't know how true that is, but that's certainly the feeling that I got, you know, being in that room. And the judge kind of gave us statistics, like there's, I don't know, like something like 80,000, some kind of immigrants become citizens in that room every year, something like that, which is quite remarkable, you know. And the judge sounded like he had pride in that, you know. He talked about the importance of becoming a citizen, of, you know, fighting for our rights as immigrants. And, you know, making sure that diversity and freedom of equality is all heard. And you know, he went in a good deal of speech about how immigration is the foundation of this country. It was very inspirational. It made me feel really patriotic. And one thing I, like, you know, people badmouth, everyone badmouths kind of the U.S. immigration policy and the department and the system. And those criticisms are extremely valid. And some, like, it's really disheartening to see how the status quo is in regards to U.S. immigration system, especially the way, you know, America treats undocumented immigrants. It's just awful, you know, in my opinion. I'm a very leftist liberal on that issue, you know. But considering all that, America is a remarkable, remarkable country, especially in terms of immigration, I think. You know, so many other countries, what I've been able to do, this paper, you know, it would be nearly impossible for me to get that in any other country, I think. My dad told me, like, so I'm from South Korea. South Korea is very, if you think immigration policy in the United States is tough, South Korea is something else. It's just, what the hell? You know, they have the worst, like, so anti-immigration policy there. It's pretty ridiculous, you know. But, I mean, that's to be expected out of a country that's 97% homogeneous. You know, 90% of the population in South Korea are South Korean citizens. And their ethnicity is South Korean, you know. Not much diversity in that country. So, 90%, 7% South Korean, like 2% other Asian, and 1% other. And the other could include, you know, it's not even like other being like, you know, from America or from European countries, but the other is mostly like, you know, Southeast Asian or Middle Eastern or things like that. Very few diversity. But my dad, you know, told me about his friend in California. His friend was born in China. Was he born in Korea? No, I think he was born in China, actually. Came to Korea as a kid, like when he was 5 years old. He has a Korean mom, but a Chinese dad. But because in countries like Korea, the paternal line matters, so his dad is Chinese. So my dad's friend is considered Chinese, not Korean, even though his mom is Korean. Even though he lived in Korea for up till like he was age 30-something, so he lived there for 20 years. He applies to be like, you know, a permanent resident. I think he is granted that. But to become a citizen, Korean government says, no, you can't be a citizen because you're Chinese, even though his mom is Korean. United States, which is ridiculous, you know. I'm able to be a U.S. citizen in America, having come from a different country with parents who are of totally different national origin. And I've been here, you know, since I was 10. I'm 26 now. So I've only been here 16 years, and I'm able to be a citizen. You know, I think that's a remarkable thing that this country should take pride in. You know, it has a horrible immigration policy, sure, but it does it so much more progressively than so many other countries. You know, immigration really is the foundation of this country, and in many times throughout United States history, it wasn't treated like that. You know, there were immigration quotas. There still kind of is, and there's, you know, this hate rhetoric surrounding immigrants and whatnot, and there still is. But, you know, I mean, that's something to be recognized for. In many European countries, you don't become a citizen just by being born in that country. Citizenship by birth is a unique thing that America has. You know, I could come into this country from Kenya or something, and have my wife or my fiance, we come to this country, she's pregnant, and the child is born in America. Guess what? That child is a U.S. citizen. You know? That's amazing. I think that's amazing. And I think it's kind of hard for many people to realize that's an amazing thing. That doesn't happen in many other countries. You can't just become a South Korean citizen just by being born in South Korea. That does not happen. You can't be a Norwegian citizen just by being in Norway. That does not happen. You know? But United States, you can become an American citizen just by being born in this country. And that is quite a remarkable thing. And I think I agree more with the United States than with another country. Immigration should be this kind of process where people can come to this country and be naturalized into being citizens with the process. It's a very frustrating and demeaning and intimidating process, but it's a process nonetheless that gets you to be a naturalized citizen. I think that's pretty important. So, as a U.S. citizen now, like, how do I feel about it overall? It hasn't kind of sunk in yet, and I don't think it ever really will. I guess the general is that I'm proud to be an American in some ways, although the nationality thing doesn't really resonate with me that much. I had my specific reasons of becoming a citizen, and for those reasons, I'm glad. You know, now I have a political voice, which I didn't really think too much about, but I do now have a political voice in this country that has weight. My name has been changed to a more better spelled, better pronounced name. I'm now eligible to be in something like U.S. Peace Corps and many other things. There are more rights and benefits that I do have. So for the benefits that I was going for the reasons that I had, I'm very glad to finally have become a U.S. citizen. And what that means to me overall, I am not sure exactly yet, but I'm here now. I am now a U.S. citizen. I am now technically an American, a Korean-American, what have you. But yeah, that's been my path. You know, and I realize my path was a pretty lucky one. It's one that I didn't have to struggle too hard for. My mom and my dad really struggled hard for me to come to this point. And I'm very thankful for my parents. And I realize many, many families have it much rougher, have it much tougher to become even just permanent residents, let alone become naturalized citizens. So I don't take this path lightly, but I am very fortunate to have been able to come this far. That's my video on this. If you guys enjoyed it, cheers.